Tydens die nasionale lockdown het 'n groep tiener-entrepreneurs van Langa besluit om in te spring en die gemeenskap te help deur 'n R9 afleweringsdiens met hulle fietsen te begin. Om self te verduidelik hoe dit werk, is Colin Kosi van Cloudy Deliveries hier vanaand. Colin, welcome to Tussen Ons. So good to have you here.
Thank you so
much. And what an exciting initiative. Was this your brainchild?
It was my brainchild. We had the idea since 2019 and eventually, in 2020, just before the lockdown, we started.
So you do deliveries for people from anywhere, from groceries, medicine, anything they want. They pay you to go and fetch it and deliver it at their homes.
So at the moment we do deliveries just in Langa. We charge, 9 rand. Mm. So, a person would call us, to go get them something from a particular shop. So we'd go to that particular shop, get them, it would be milk, it would be bread, and we'll come back again. And
why 9 rand? Why not 10?
Yeah,
I was thinking about it. Less than
10 rand. I don't know, it just came across my mind, just charge 9 rand for now. And then, but people are paying us 10 rand, they pay us 15
yeah, no,
rand,
20 rand. Yeah, keep the 1 rand.
And who's mostly your clients? Is it like, because I can think the elderly who need the service, this has come at the right time for them because they're so vulnerable, now they don't have to go outside. Mm. And how big is your team and what, just explain to us how you go about this.
So our clients, would be elderly people, a lot of elderly people, and also young women as well. In our team we have, a group of 11 boys and 2 young boys who are mechanics. They're 12 years old, so they come in the morning, they'll prepare the bicycles for the older ones.
So they do the bikes themselves?
They do the bikes in the morning from 8 to 10, and then 10 o'clock the older ones would come in and do the deliveries.
That is so exciting. So you have someone also takes care of the bicycles, the servicing.
Yeah, we do that on our own at the moment. So I have 2 12-year-old boys, as I said. So they come in, they fix, they prepare the tires and everything. And then at 10 o'clock, the older ones come in and
go. You are the perfect example of bring solutions, not problems.
Yeah.
Well done to you.
Thanks
and where
lot.
Does the bikes come from?
So in 2019, I was working part-time at Old Mutual, so I saved some of the money, and then after I saved enough money, I bought 11 second-hand bicycles, and then we started off in 2020.
Wow, well done.
This is incredible. And how many bikes do you have on the road now?
So at the moment, we have 9 bicycles on the road, 2 are damaged, all of our bicycles got damaged, the second-hand bicycles, all of them got damaged, and so we had a good guy called Tony from Ikhayelanga. He offered us to use his bicycles. So at the moment we're using 7 of his bicycles and 2 of our own bicycles that we managed to fix.
Wow. Yeah. So I hate to ask, but this is South Africa and bikes will be stolen. Mm. How do you safeguard yourselves from theft? People stealing your stuff and...
Well, our community, I think we have people that patrol the streets. So, the boys are able to drive at night, and during the day. So,
we know they go out at night as well?
Like maybe 6, around 7.
But the people know them now?
They know them,
So,
we have people that patrol the streets. And, if anything would happen, we'd go to the
older men
in the community and, tell them that, this is something that happened, and they would look for whatever that got lost.
And what's the big dream? To become a delivery service, is that where you're heading?
This is so phenomenal. I want to come back to what Zelda said about being part of a solution and Mrs. Jones in South Africa, because we've heard so many times, like delivery, the modern, they don't want to go into townships because they are afraid. But the people have the need. I mean, and from the youth men, this is fantastic. I just think it's great, and what can we do to get more bicycles? Because do you have more guys who want to ride with you?
A lot of people every day, young boys, would knock on the door, they say they want to join, and we would have to say, we have to save up a bit of money to fix the old ones. And even if we fix the old ones, they get damaged again. Because
where do people find you if they want to support you in whatever way, with bikes or with...
So they would contact, me on my cell phone, or they would look on our social media, Facebook page, which is Cloudy Deliveries, and, they would try to contact us from there on.
So, Colin, we've brought a friend here. We've invited someone from Laura Sport, Robin Hendricks. Welcome to Tussen Ons. Good to have you here.
Thanks so much for having me, man. It's so nice to be here.
You, Laura Sport, you actually mostly do football kits and things.
That's right. Obviously, with lockdown and COVID, we've been forced to move in products that we don't normally produce, such as surgical wear, and obviously face masks is quite popular. So, initially we started off only producing football kits and tracksuits, and that was about 4 years ago, and we've seen a tremendous amount of growth within the Western Cape. So yeah, we just at this point in time so happy to be one of the businesses that can still produce during this period.
Yes,
that's one of the things that I think we need to be grateful for. So yeah, sure.
But more than producing, you're also reaching out now. So why are you here this evening?
Yes, so I was told it's a surprise, and you can't not be inspired by the story that he's just brought. I mean, you compare Uber Eats and all these amazing delivery vehicles that we have at the moment now, and for somebody to take that initiative and run with it in a township, and it's you want to get involved. So from our side as a brand, what we're going to do is for the rainy winter period, we're going to provide you guys with some jackets.
Wow. There we go. If you look behind you.
Wow.
So we're going to provide you with some guys with some jackets, and then some face masks as well, which I've brought along, and there are some face masks left over for you lovely ladies as well. But yeah, so any other way in terms of pants and tracksuits, we'd love to continue this relationship,
because
once off doesn't really help. We see potential in this, so yes, it's something that we want to continue doing as well.
That is incredible. Colin, what would you like to say?
No, we're really thankful for that, because you know, it was just last week when we were speaking with the boys that we needed to get, you know, tracksuits, you know, so that they'd be able to work during winter, and you know, for this to happen, you know, it really means a lot. And you know, I can't wait to tell the boys, you know, that you know, they'll be getting you know, tech tops, you know, to wear when it's cold. You know, we're really thankful for this. Thank you so much.
No problem.
So big thank you to Robin at Laura Sport, and to you too, Colin, for this incredible initiative. This is fantastic.
Thank you. Thank
well
you.
Done. Thank you very much. So groet dankie aan hulle almal, en dis tyd vir ons om te groet. Kom kuier weer volgende week saam, en tot dan gaan kyk na ons foto's en video's op Facebook. Tot volgende week.